ChargerLab has introduced the UGREEN Nexode RG Charger Series, which has a striking and unique robot design. It is also equipped with a display that can help you check the charging mode directly. Today we got a 65W version from this exact series. Let's take it apart to see its internal components. The front of the box adopts a translucent design. Here is the UGREEN logo. The 65W is printed at the lower right corner. And there are 4 selling points printed on this side. Open the box, it contains the charger and some documents. Remove the protective film on the display. As a member of the UGREEN Nexode RG Charger Series, it looks like a cool and adorable robot. The 65W is engraved on the back. There is a black headset on the head of the robot, giving it a chatty look. Both sides have a concave design to fit your fingers. There are purple USB-A and 2 black USB-C ports on the top. The detachable shoe cap has internal magnet for better fixing and makes the charger more stable when not in use. All specs info are printed below the AC blocks. Model is CD361. It can support input of 120V, 50 or 60Hz, 1.8 amp. When used individually, the highest output for USB-C 1 to USB-A is 65W, 30W, 22.5W respectively. And the total output power can reach 65W. The size of it is about 50x47x41mm. And the length with the shoe cap is about 67mm. It is obviously smaller than the Apple 61W charger. The total weight is about 140 grams. The weight is about 131 grams after removing the shoe cap. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows that USB-C 1 can support FCP, SCP, AGFC, QC 3.0, 5, SFCP, PD 3.0, PPS, DCP, Samsung 2M, and Apple 2.4M charging protocols. And it has 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PPS. The USB-C 2 supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, 4+, SFCP, PD 3.0, PPS, DCP, Samsung 2M, and Apple 2.4M charging protocols. And it has 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 9V, 3A, 12V, 2.5A, 15V, 2A, 20V, 1.5A, and a set of PPS. The USB-A supports charging protocols such as FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, SFCP, DCP, Samsung 2M, and Apple 2.4M. Next, let's start to take it apart. First, use a spudger and a hammer to remove the bottom cover. The PCB module is filled with pink potting compound for better heat dissipation. Use a cutting machine to remove the remaining case. Take out the PCBA module and clean up the potting compound. The PCBA module is composed of 3 small PCBs. ChargerLab found it adopts a flatback topology with synchronous rectification and fixed voltage output. And it has 2 synchronous buck circuits to achieve 3-port fast charging and automatic power distribution. Next, take a look at each component, starting from the input end. The input fuse is from WalterFuse, 3.15A, 250V. The safety X2 capacitor is from DGCX, 0.1 microfarad. The common mode choke is wound with magnet and insulated wires. The bridge rectifier is from World Industrial. It has good heat dissipation and adopts LSB package. The NTC resistor marked with 1.5D-7 is used to suppress surge current. The differential mode choke is wound with an I-shaped magnetic core and is insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. These two electrolytic capacitors for input filtering are from Acon, 47 microfarad, 400 volts for each. Then move to the primary side. The GaN IC is from SouthChip. It integrates multiple functions and adopts a QFN 6x8 package. These two SMDY capacitors are from TRX. The optocoupler is from CTMICRO. It is used for output voltage feedback. Then let's take a look at the synchronous rectification circuit. Its controller is from SouthChip and it supports adaptive terminal detection and fast shutdown. The synchronous rectifier is from WAYON and adopts PDFN 5060-8L package, 100 volts, 6.3 milliohm. These two solid capacitors for output filtering are from APAQ, 220 microfarad, 25 volts, 560 microfarad, 25 volts, respectively. Next, let's take a look at the buck circuit of USB-C1. The buck controller of USB-C1 is from iSmartWare. It supports charging of any USB-C and USB-A ports, and dual port independent current limiting. The buck MOSFET is from iSmartWare. The buck inductor is wound with magnet wires. These two solid capacitors are used for input filtering, 150 microfarad, 25 volts for each. The other two solid capacitors are used for output filtering, 220 microfarad, 25 volts for each. The VBUS MOSFET used for USB-C1 is marked with B3006. After that, here is the buck circuit of USB-C2 and USB-A. The dual port buck controller is from iSmartWare. It integrates the 5M synchronous buck converter and supports multiple charging protocols. The buck inductor is insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. The dual-channel VBUS MOSFET used for USB-C2 and USB-A is from NCE and adopts PDFN 3.3x3.3-8L package, 30 volts, 11 milliohm. The MCU is used to distribute output power and control the LED lights. The USB-C sockets have black plastic sheets. The purple USB-A socket has widened pins for high current. Remove the black plastic cover. There are 7 LED indicator lights under it. Well, those are all components of this charger. You can check the output modes through the expressions on the display, and the shoe cap can protect the AC plugs. After taking it apart, we found the entire module are filled with potting compound for fixing. It is composed of 3 small PCBs and the internal components are stacked together to save space. If you're attracted by its special robot design and the power of 65 watts in such a small size, then you might as well give it a try. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!